guys, so I am so excited to share these three amazing tips to instantly stop a panic attack. Now, your mind is so powerful that I feel like if you really put effort into these three tips, that I am certain that these will stop a panic attack. So stay tuned and let's get to it. Start with saying is a lot of these tips have to do with your mind. Now for me, the physical things that they recommend, like for example, deep breathing techniques, when I'm having a panic attack or that sort of thing, a lot of my issues are with my chest. So if my heart's racing, I'm having heart palpitations, and I'm trying to do these like breathe in, breathe out techniques, what happens is that, for me personally, they may work for some others, but what happens is that when I breathe in and then when I slowly breathe out, so it's like my heart rate will slow down, but then when I breathe out, it's like it's going faster than it was before. And I don't know. They just, a lot of them don't work for me. So I hated to also title this panic attack because I feel like it can work for a panic attack, an anxiety attack, just an ongoing, like, obsessing over one certain symptom attack. So, yeah, just a little, like, background on that. But, again, I'll repeat it one more time. It's a lot to do with your mind. These aren't, they are physical things you can do a little bit, but for the most part, your mind is so, so, so strong. So, okay, I'll stop babbling. First thing is that you have to, before things get crazy, recognize that you are having a panic attack. And that's so dumb to say, but it's so true, because when I start feeling a panic attack coming on, or when I'm feeling a physical symptom or an anxiety attack or whatever it has to do, the minute I start thinking that there's something seriously wrong with me, it all gets blown out of proportion. So the first thing that's so important is to, even if you don't believe it, because a lot of the times I, you know, really do think there's something seriously going on, even if you don't believe it, like I said, your mind is so powerful. You have to just sit there and, I am having a panic attack. I am having a panic attack. This is a panic attack. An unwanted thought goes through your head that says that you're going to have a seizure or you have a blood clot somewhere. No, don't even feed into it at all. Not even a little bit. Don't start Googling something, because then you for sure will have it. You know, so no, sit there and say, I'm having a panic attack. Don't let your mind start thinking you have all these other crazy things going on. That is the very first and most important step. Now, you guys can look into this, but it's called tapping therapy, and there are tons of studies, like Mayo Clinic, every big places have done studies, and it's shown to be helpful. So I guess that there's two main spots that you can tap, so up here on your cheekbone, and then also like right here on your hand. You can just sit there and tap, and don't really know how it works, the science behind it all, but it does work. And I don't know if that, along with telling yourself you're not having a panic attack, I don't know which one maybe is the best, because I do them together. So if you're at home, you know, you can just like sit here like, I'm not, this sounds dumb. And I think because it's so simple, people don't think it works. But, and I think that's why it's not really talked about, because it's something so simple that you can do that people just don't think it works. Try it. Please try it. So anyway, just, I'm not having a panic attack. This is not a panic attack. I'm not having a panic attack. If you're in public, you know, in your head, maybe tell yourself, I'm not having a panic attack, and touch right there. So worth giving it a shot, worth giving it a try. My second thing now that I want to talk about. So you know you're not having a panic attack. You're using the tapping technique to kind of like maybe calm things down. The science behind that's weird. You guys look it up. Tell me what you think about it. But so Number two. The second thing for me is that you need to convince yourself you're not having a heart attack. So you know you're having a panic attack. You know this is all that it is. And guess what, guys? A panic attack has never killed anybody. Yeah, they suck. They really suck. But they don't really hurt you. They're just fine. It's just crappy part of life that you have to deal with, I have to deal with, it sucks, it is what it is, you'll get through it. So now, on to the second thing that I want to talk about is to convince yourself that you're also not having a heart attack. And maybe this just goes hand in hand for me personally, but I know there's a lot of others out there that have heart issues when they're having an anxiety attack, a panic attack, or just obsessing over their heart or that kind of thing, or even your jaw. Do you have jaw pain, arm pain, and you're thinking you're having a heart attack? Now, I will say this, and I know for sure, I've read a lot of places that over 90% of people with chest pain, that's not related to your chest. And for sure, 85%, because a Mayo Clinic study was done and it showed that people that have gone in with chest pain, 85% of the time, it had nothing to do with their heart. Indigestion causes it, you know, just all these things, stress, tension, blah, 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 blah. So if you're having chest pain, just knowing that in the back of your head that 85 to 90% of people having chest pain, it's not nothing to do with your heart, you know? So, with that being said, if you're anything like me, you're like, oh, what about that 10%? Oh, what about this time? Nope, no, no, no. Do not let your mind do that. You know, just tell yourself those kind of facts. Like, and how many times have you guys had chest pain before? Yeah, this time it probably feels different than all the other times, like every time, but you're fine. So convince yourself you're having a panic attack. Try this tapping technique. Like I said, look it up. I'm not crazy. It really works. I guess I am crazy, but I'm not that crazy. I wouldn't lie to you guys. I just want to help you out. And then to convince yourself you're not having a heart attack. How many times have you had chest pain before? Really? How many times have you had chest pain before? Nothing's probably ever came of it. If you're like me, you've had all these tests done. Nothing's ever came up. They would have caught something by now if it was something. Now, the third and final thing for me, a lot of times when I'm having a panic attack or unwanted thoughts or any of that kind of big category of crappy stuff, is that you feel like you're losing control. You're just completely losing your mind. You're losing control. You know, maybe you're going to act on doing something crazy that you absolutely don't want to do, or that your mind's thinking maybe you want to do. How come anxiety is so hard to explain? But you guys know what I mean. So you have to show yourself that you're in control. I am not going crazy. I am in control. So the first thing that I do is like, what don't I feel like doing right now? You know, because you're feeling pretty crappy if you're having a panic attack or whatever. What don't I want to do? Well, I probably just want to lay in bed and feel sorry for myself and Google all my symptoms. But what you have to do is get up and move around. Whether that's walking out to your mailbox, your mind's telling you that it doesn't want to do these things. You show them that you can do these things. So get up, walk out to the mailbox, grab the mail. Look, you just did something that your mind was telling you couldn't do because you're in control. Dumb little things. Drink a bottle of water. Things that you know that are good for you. To do a little workout. Anything. Cook a meal. You know, maybe you're laying in bed and you don't want to cook supper for your family tonight. Like, which is totally fine. We have cereal nights. We have all those nights. But I'm just saying, for an example, that, you know, your mind's telling you, I'm not going to cook supper tonight. You know, the kids are going to have a peanut butter sandwich and whatever it is, what it is. Make yourself, show yourself you are in control and get up and do something. So, you know, that way, it's just a mind thing. So I am in control. And as much as you don't want to, get up and do whatever it is to show yourself that you're in control. I like to do three things. So make a list of three things. So, you know, like, for example, the walking out to the mailbox, getting the mail. I did that. I am in control, you know. Something as dumb as doing 10 lunges. Look, I just did these 10 lunges. I am in control. And then making supper for your family. Like, yeah, I felt like shit, didn't want to. My mind was telling me I wasn't going to do this. But you did it because you are in control. Yeah. Yes, you are. So, okay. Those are my three instant ways to help you guys stop a panic attack instantly. And I honestly, honestly believe that these really will work. So, you guys are going to convince yourself, yes, I'm having a panic attack. Try the tapping theory. Look it up. Number two, you are not having a heart attack. No, you're not. No, you're not. No, you're not. And then number three, I'm not going crazy and I am in control. I am in control. I am in control. So give those three things a try. Please, please let me know if they work for you guys, because I would love, love, love to know that this helps somebody out. So if you guys would like to see more videos like this, or just some random fun videos that, you know, kind of show you guys people with anxiety, you can overcome it and you can still live a fun, normal life. So if you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe. I would love it to have you guys along this journey with me. I'm still learning, but it's been so much fun. Give this video a thumbs up and put a comment down below. Like, if you have a panic attack and tried these things and it worked, or if you think they're complete BS, comment down below. I'd love to know. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.